all of them say they've known you forever, but they all pronounce your last name differently. So.
Ah, there it is. That's the test. But I don't think a lot of my good, like, childhood friends even know how to spell say my last name.
So set the
it's
record
so toughy.
Straight.
It's Dryminus.
I was right. I am Brandy Taylor. This is the Sonic EdmonTour, and this is Peter and Leia from July Talk.
Hi, guys.
What's up?
Where was the very first show you played in Edmonton?
It's in that basement, but what was
guess
that
it was
from?
When New City was on White.
Oh, yeah.
You know when it was that basement? Was that the first time?
I think so.
Yeah, I guess that would have been the first time.
So when you guys started out and first started playing shows in Edmonton, obviously you would probably stay with Peter's family, right?
Yeah, totally.
So it was kind of like a home, second home. Like when we would, obviously at the time, we were sleeping on floors and all cramming into
minivans.
And
luckily, Peter's parents keep clean floors. We're here at the Pagalac. It's the Pagalac, right?
The Pagalac.
We're here at the Pagalac. Pete has been talking about it for as long as I've known him.
I think generally with my family, we would kind of be here in the middle of the winter like three nights a week sometimes.
It's great broth.
Yeah, it's good broth.
I'm gonna give it a try.
The way you gotta eat pho though, there's a very specific way you gotta eat pho. You gotta get the beef on the side. You put that into your soup while it's still really hot to let it cook, but not. You don't want them to do it because then it'll just be too cooked. You gotta put all the basil in here. You gotta squeeze your lime into the pho. And then you season it to taste with hot sauce and hoisin.
You're like Emeril. I love it.
Bam!
Who was your favorite Edmonton band when you lived here, and who's your favorite Edmonton band now?
You know, I think that perspective is very different. It's always changing. Wednesday Night Heroes were the band that were like the rock stars when I was growing up. They were the coolest band there was. That transitioned into kind of Shout Out, 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 Out when Nick Kozeb and them started playing with Clint and stuff, which was so cool. But I think now when I'm coming back, I'm so interested in Faith Healer. I think they're so cool. They got a record coming out in September, as well as Faith Healer's guitarist, John Coleman's project. I don't know if you know that, but it's like just so cool. Everything that like Renee Wilson, I guess his name is, I don't really know him. Everything that he does is just like out of the park.
I feel like any art scene too that has Edmontonians come into it in a specific city, like there's something about the vibe of the people here and the art being created and like the loyalty to the city and like being proud, Edmonton pride and stuff like that. Like it's a really, I think any city that has like that attracts people from Edmonton, like the art scene, is really lucky to have it.
I know, man, go back to the king. We're at Free Cloud Records, right across the street from my high school.
Is this the place that when we drove by and our show poster was in the window, you were like,
no? So cool. I mean, yeah, this is Rich Hanover. He told us what was cool, what wasn't cool. We would come here every lunch hour, spend our parents' money on records.
Lunch hour, you guys were skipping.
Yeah, it wasn't exactly lunch hour. Quote unquote lunch hour. Leia's got a few. They're
I can't buy them
a little predictable.
I can't afford them. I know.
Recognize it? You could say she's a pretty hip lady.
Tragically.
Tragically, unfortunately.
Tragically, I can't afford them all.
Are there any like secret Edmonton references hidden in any songs?
I mean, yeah, there's like lots of lyrics on the first record that are about Edmonton. Rash and Well is all about Edmonton.
Facts. That was the first song that Peter, like when we first met, he sent me a link to a MySpace page, I think it was.
Yeah, yeah.
That had Rash and Well. I like put it on mixtapes that like summer, and just like I listened to it so many times on the page that I nothing was like, I'm like listening to this, I'm listening to these songs an embarrassing amount. I'd like you to send me the MP3 version of this song so that you can't tell how many times I'm accounting for these like plays. Anyway,
and then you get like skewing his stats, right?
Yeah,
there's no wrong answer to this. Would you guys consider yourself partially an Edmonton band?
I mean, I don't know how the Edmonton scene would feel about this. And I have so much respect for them, so I don't really want to, like, piss anyone off.
I'd say this. I wouldn't call us an Edmonton fan. I would say that Edmonton, I still consider Edmonton home. Yeah, I mean, an Edmonton band, that means a lot of things. A lot of bands have stuck it out here and really contributed to the scene over the years and played local shows and booked their own shows and got venues started, like, really important bands. And I'm not going to pretend that we've contributed to this scene even close to that way. But I still think that, I think that the city means a lot to us. We're back. We're at the end of the world. This used to be Keeler Road, and it was a highway that collapsed into the river valley. The first time we came to Edmonton, I think, we came out here and I took a photo of Leia right out on the edge, where we are now.
Seems like a really dangerous place to drink a Mickey.
Thanks so much for joining us for our tour of Edmonton. It was so cool to be able to go back to all the old favorite spots.
We love you, E-Town.
So good to be here. Thanks so much for having us.